Good afternoon, guys, from our hometown of Seward, Alaska. And we dropped a bomb last week about selling our motorhome, and also we bought an expedition vehicle. And there were a ton of questions on that video. So this is just going to be like a simple one, not overly complex. So I'm going to warn you, it's probably going to be a little bit on the long side. We are in a location here at the base of the Mount Marathon Trail in Lowell Canyon. So we'll send the drone up at the very end, but this is just going to be a hangout with us type of a day. Before we answer the specific questions in the comments from that video, how about some generalized information about the vehicle? So it's a 2007 Mitsubishi Fuso four-wheel drive. Fuso is owned by Daimler, which is Mercedes, which means it's going to have ample opportunities for securing parts and service around the world. Five-speed manual transmission. Something that's really cool is it's got a high-low transfer case, so it means that you're not always going to be in four-wheel drive. A lot of those Unimogs and military vehicles are full-time four-wheel drive. You don't always need to be spending the energy pushing those front wheels. So this is really nice. And it's factory four-wheel drive to boot. Locking hubs, just good old-fashioned turn them and lock. A limited slip positive traction rear end. No diesel exhaust fluid or ultra-low sulfur diesel requirements. A block heater. Anti-lock brakes, heated mirrors, air conditioning for the chassis, the cab of the truck, Earth Cruiser springs and rad flow shocks for extra ride quality and ground clearance, I'm sure. The Earth Cruiser, they're a manufacturer of expedition vehicles, and they have accessories for the Fusos. There are five of the Earth Cruiser wheels. And what's special about these, especially in the rear, because this vehicle has dual rear wheels from the factory, which are great for the highway, but not necessarily good for off-road because rocks can get stuck in the middle. So these have one single, like, wide wheel on the back to replace those dualies.
Specially made for this kind of vehicle.
Yeah. 60 gallons of fuel capacity divided between two tanks, two starter batteries, custom rear bumper and swing out tire mount, EGR block off plates, they're included but not installed. That's part of the exhaust gas recirculation system. I want to research that a little more whether I do it, but the principles of it totally make sense. You know, better fuel economy, more efficiency when you're not running exhaust back through the engine to be reburned. He does have the repair manual via CD or PDF. And now it's time for the camper. This is you.
This is me. Okay.
Still trying to kick this cough.
All right, so I'll talk a little bit about how we came to choose this vehicle, how much we spent, because there's a little bit of a background story here. So our top line that we really had originally budgeted for was $60,000. And $80,000 was really like the max we wanted to spend.
As we got into it, $60,000 wasn't enough.
No, and we could have. It really actually was enough. But it wasn't enough for what we wanted, and we decided $28,000 difference probably was worth paying so that we could have what we ultimately wanted, not what we might just be happy with for a year or two.
Keep in mind, there were still a ton of compromises, because an RV purchase is all about compromises.
Yeah, unless you build from the bottom up yourself
and have an unlimited budget, there's compromises.
Yeah, there are. So, and the compromises are the interior. You know, we're going to redo some work on that, because, and it's not because anything is of poor quality, really. It's just not necessarily our taste. In fact, the reason that we did agree to go ahead and purchase this was because, number one, the chassis, you just can't beat it. It's got low mileage, serviceable all around the globe. It had everything we wanted and lots of upgrades. And then, as far as the box went, they didn't skimp when it came to installing systems. It has 520 watts of solar power. Like, that's enough for us, for sure.
The interior is very homemade, do-it-yourself, but at the same time, that's kind of good, because that means we can do it ourselves to our own liking.
Yeah.
Because I'll tell you right off the bat, we need to add more electrical outlets.
Mm-hmm. And I'm getting rid of the green, for sure.
John Deere girl is getting rid of the green. That's just so ironic.
Oh,
contradictory to your first words.
It is, but it just isn't my color scheme, you know?
But we'll have the opportunity to make it our own.
We will. And there's room to do that. But really, it had like a great heating system in it. It's a single fuel source vehicle. And so we decided that the things that we were compromising on were things we could easily fix and change ourselves. They weren't crucial components of the vehicle.
Another, just as we wrap this little portion up, thought is that we just also decided to go over our budget because this vehicle is more of an expedition vehicle versus a four-wheel drive sprinter van. A four-wheel drive sprinter van would do, like, get you down to the beach, dirt roads, muddy roads. But we saw the opportunity for a true expedition vehicle, and we also thought, not that I give a rat's blah what people think, but from a marketing standpoint or a viewership or appealing to viewer standpoint, we really thought that, hey, this vehicle that's a little more on the extreme side would draw more viewers in. And I really could care less what people think, but we liked the vehicle and we thought, hey, this would probably more than pay for itself having Ben and Rebecca drive around in a badass expedition vehicle instead of a 4x4 sprinter van.
Yeah.
Okay, Beck just touched on some of these, but I'm going to go through the some of the specs on the camper. So the box, it's aluminum wall that's not composite. Outside is 13 feet 5 inches, 6 foot 11 wide, which is narrow, but yet in a good way because the places that we're going. The approximate inside is 13 by 6.5. It has a queen size bed. That's massive, guys.
And really hard to find.
Yeah, we found a lot of vehicles that hit most of the marks except they had a double bed. Kitchen counter at this time, you know, it's going to be modified, but 60 inches long. And the dinette is 36 inches wide. All single fuel source, no propane. So it's DC and diesel appliances. 520 solar. Let's see here. 3 Optima yellow top batteries. A 41 liter DC powered freezer, which is nice. You know, we're kind
we
of excited
really
about
to
that.
A freezer to be able to keep extra food.
Yeah, and a 75 liter refrigerator. We're going to be
gonna change that out.
We're going to be messing around with this stuff when we make it our own. It has an S-Par hydronic heating system with 2 radiators, one by the dinette, one by the bed, and that's like a radiator that gets the hot water from the S-Par and blows the A fan blows through there and
really,
you know, gives
nice
your heat.
It's not going to be wet heat like the propane that we've been used to all these years.
Yep. It also runs to the engine, so you can preheat your engine.
And you have hot water when you park the vehicle.
Yeah.
You can hop right in the shower and have
exactly
6 gallons of really hot water.
Yeah, it has an isotherm 6 gallon hot water heater.
Yes, I have that memorized.
Wallace diesel stove, 2 burner. Queen mattress, full shower, and cassette toilet. Flip down dining table, converts to a bed. That's pretty standard. Max air fan, very similar to like a Fantastic fan for the ceiling. There's insulation in the walls.
Yeah, this was a really important factor for us because the owners, the current owners, live in Montana, and they have done a lot of winter camping in this and been very comfortable and warm. And that spoke to us because that's an area of the country that gets really cold.
Exactly. And, you know, we know that for our budget, we weren't getting a vehicle that we could drive to Antarctica. Yeah. Think about it. I know I'm making a joke. But it's not an Antarctica-grade vehicle. But it is
a capable vehicle.
Let's see here. So there's an air compressor, 40 gallons of fresh water. We
probably
would definitely
be expanded on that.
Before Africa and Asia, do that. LED lighting in and out. Battery combiner,
it
so
has
charges.
An air compressor. You missed that.
I said that.
Oh,
I thought.
Okay.
It has an air compressor. So you know, it manages the charge from the battery and the solar and all that. There's an inverter that needs to be wired into the outlets. The box is on a 3-point mounting system with bump stops, and so the chassis and the box are essentially two different things. So they're going to be able to flex and work well together. Now that's it. So those are the specs, guys. question time.
This will be fun.
So forgive us if we mispronounce any of the names here, but Chi Jenkins wants to know where and when will we be picking it up.
All right, so where, that's easy to answer. It's in Montana.
Livingston.
Yes. When is still a little bit up in the air. because we're still deciding whether, and I think this morning we kind of made the decision that we won't be driving it back to Alaska.
That was the original idea. Let's get it back home to Alaska and load it up and hit the road. And in our mind, the Alaska Highway, that's just the Alaska Highway. But then we got to thinking about it, that's like 5,400 miles again that we've driven plenty of times.
And frankly, I'm tired.
Yeah, I'm tired of it. You know, there's nothing I hate more than going down a road again. Exactly. Like, that's a waste of your life driving down the same road.
Yeah. So I had looked into like U-Hauls and other ways to get our stuff down there, and they were considerably more expensive than just driving it round trip. So what we finally talked about, I don't know why this didn't occur to me sooner.
Just a ton of USPS boxes.
Yeah, but we'll just mail everything down in USPS boxes. We just did this for Ben's grandpa, and it was cheaper to send 20 boxes up here than it would be for us to drive round trip by like half.
Yeah, we're thinking maybe $1,000 each way, which would, you know, if we maybe spend $1,000 on shipping, we're still money ahead and 2 weeks of our lives ahead.
That could be laying on the beach in North Carolina or something.
That has value. Let's just say that.
Lots of value.
All right, next, I'll just ask this one. Angie wanted to know how much it's going to cost to ship it to Europe.
Okay, so I can answer this. The best quote I've gotten to date is $27.73. And that includes everything. That includes the cost of the export taxes here, the import fees over in Europe. It includes the shipping on the boat. It includes insuring the vehicle. And then there's a couple of other expenses. I have them all written out, you know, like itemized, but two other expenses that they have for the vehicle. So I was actually really, it came in like $1,000 under what I expected
it to be. And there's maybe still an Overland Sphere discount, which is like an Overlanding website, and they have discounts and whatnot.
I need to call them after the holiday weekend and talk to them, because I just did that quote last week.
But they come up with these numbers based off the size of the vehicle.
And a point about this too is that this particular company, it's out of the US or Canada, we can ship from either, and it's into Belgium. So odds are we'll probably ship out of Baltimore and ship it into Belgium.
But right now, things can totally change. Just what we're thinking at. Like, you guys saw how many times things changed for the vehicle itself.
Yeah.
Sunny wanted to know about our travel plans. So we kind of covered from Montana. We may just go up to the house and go back.
Or we may fly down. We may just ship stuff.
Ship everything
That's
down.
That's what I'm voting for.
Yeah.
And leave from Montana appealing. To the East Coast, and then ship from the East Coast to Europe.
But keep in mind, there is going to be a victory lap across the United States. We're going to be meeting up with you guys, going cool places. And I'm calling it a victory lap because we have worked hard for this.
Really hard.
And damn right, we deserve
to share the vehicle
a really cool trek across the country, going to all these amazing places. At places that we couldn't go before.
Yeah. And then once we're actually traveling, we plan to do Europe for a couple of years, then Africa, Asia, Australia, South America, Central America, and back home.
And there's going to be
a very rough outline.
Yeah. And it's all fluid. Yeah. But in Europe, we're going to have to juggle the Schengen district and be in and out for
every 90 days.
So there's going to be a lot of moving around.
But we actually measured like the farthest possible distances, and it's only 700 miles would be the absolute max we'd have to drive to get out of the Schengen district.
Yeah, from like Belgium to the Schengen district of, was that Romania?
I think you did it to Zagreb.
So
Croatia.
Yeah, it was only like 700 miles, which is, that's a long day drive for us.
Yeah,
so it's
like
not far.
Days.
We got to keep that in mind.
Mm-hmm.
See here, next on the list, Linda wanted to know where we've been. Well, I had a cold for
5 weeks.
5 weeks.
You know, been so sick.
3.5, 4 of which were just absolute misery.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, I have my voice again, so we can now vlog to you guys.
And we worked really hard to get Nelly ready to sell,
do
some things to our house, get things. We're cleaning out everything so that when we leave, the house is the way it should be and really easy to be taken care of.
Yep. So since we're talking about the house, Joyce asked, what are we doing with our house?
We're keeping it.
Yeah. We love Alaska.
We love our home.
We love our home. We have caretakers that, you know, watch over the place while we're away. Yep. It works.
It does.
You know, why we give up the house to. If you don't have to?
Financially, you know? We don't have to, so we won't.
Exactly. Cut and dry.
Mm-hmm.
Sunny asked, I covered Sunny. Gary Gadget wanted to know how much it cost. Well,
$88,000
for that expedition vehicle.
Yep.
No, not bad at all. And there is a video coming. We're going to talk about ownership of our Tiffin, mm-hmm. like what we bought it for 7 years ago and what we sold it for, mm-hmm. and some of the things that came out of pocket for repairs. Mm-hmm. See here, Trevor wants to know, have you verified that you can bring a non-DEF equipped diesel to Europe?
So they have lots of these vehicles, because if you buy expedition vehicles in Europe, most of them are built on chassis out of the 80s and
or 90s or 70s even.
Yeah. And we're doing a temporary import permit, so we actually are going to get a carnet, and we'll be doing...
Or carnet. We're not sure yet.
Well, in French it would be carnet.
Exactly.
In English it would be carnet. And so that will cover us for importing our vehicle temporarily to about 80 countries around the world. We'll do a whole video about shipping this thing and getting all of the import permits done and everything.
Once we've lived it, we can give a more educational video
about
that. And I'm
actually, to go with our new website, I'm working on an ebook about shipping your vehicle overseas as we go through this process. But... with a temporary import pass, it is permissible to bring a vehicle in because you're not actually having to meet emissions requirements there.
Righty Tighty asked about transporting a vehicle through Canada.
It's
no big deal. A lot of Alaskans go to the lower 48 and drive it back up here.
Yeah.
No big deal.
As long as you have the paperwork. We actually were at the DMV the other day and we checked in with her. She said as long as you have your receipt of sale and the copy of their registration and proof of purchase, you're fine.
Yeah, and speaking of which, like, another reason why we're maintaining our house is there are benefits to living in Alaska, mm-hmm. and having it as your domicile.
Yeah.
Obviously, we've traveled enough that we've given up our PFD. We don't qualify for that.
No, haven't.
But we still get to register vehicles for $175 for 2 years, guys. Mm-hmm. And it doesn't really matter how much the vehicle costs.
Nope.
Like, if you buy a $300,000 vehicle motorhome in California, look out. You're going to be spending thousands upon thousands of dollars every single year. And taxes, exactly. Sales tax on $88,000.
Yeah.
That'd suck eggs. Here in Alaska?
It's rolled into your registration.
Exactly.
Fees, which is actually kind of the way that they do it in the UK.
Several people asked about the music from that video. So we got some pretty awesome footage of some sea otters in the harbor on that last video. And we get our music from Pond 5, at least right now we do. And that music track was called Nice and Soft Hip Hop.
Mm-hmm.
George, this is sarcastically, why would you want to go anywhere else? In reference to the beautiful scenery we have here in Alaska.
We do so very much appreciate it.
But... Oh, yeah. But why not? Life is short. We want to live it to the fullest and
see as much as we can.
See as much as we can. That's
and
our
we've
thing.
We've lived here 10 years. We've enjoyed and appreciated the beauty of Alaska, and we're really looking forward to enjoying and appreciating new beauty.
Yeah. And our trip,
beautiful in some way.
Our around the world trip doesn't have an end date, guys.
Mm-mm.
This is a whole
lifestyle.
It's not like we have to be back in a year.
Mm-mm.
So who knows where this road is going to take us. A lot of people have asked about Shelby, not specifically in this video. Of course, mm-hmm. our baby girl is going with us. We have her tied up to a tree, not in any cool way. She's totally
she's
enjoying
the grass
and
sunny weather.
All that.
But she's going with us. We had to make sure she had a chip. And she had to have an updated rabies vaccine, which we did all of that this spring.
Yeah.
And when we get, and then she'll have to do some USDA paperwork before we leave the country. Probably on the East Coast, mm-hmm. we'll end up doing it because it has to be done within 10 days of travel.
And there will be a whole video on that topic as well once we live it. This is now just talking about our plans.
Exactly. But she'll fly in the airplane in the cabin with us, not in cargo hold. She's yep. tiny enough to go underneath the seat.
She can hold her potty for a long time. You know, 6 hours. Yep. Especially if we do an overnight flight when she's used to holding it for 6 or 8 hours. Yeah.
And once we get to Europe, we have 4 months to get her what's called a pet passport. And once she has that, she can travel around the EU with no troubles at all. And each country has their own requirements, and we'll work through that as we move along. But I've talked to people who've taken their dogs to Africa and India and Asia. Yeah. It's doable.
It is.
We just have to work through each place we're going. And we'll share that with you as we go.
Last question, AK by choice. I wanted to know what the name of the vehicle is going to be. And we're going to involve you guys in this process. But right now, I'll tell you what I'm leaning towards. I'm leaning towards Denali. And in Alaska, the name Denali is the name of formerly Mount McKinley, the tallest peak in North America. But in the native dialect, Denali means the great one. I think that's very suiting. But the problem with it is it's a very cliche name here.
For Alaskans.
In Alaska. But we have a population of like 750,000, you know. People name their dogs Denali or Kodiak or Cody. Like, so yeah, it may be a cliche name for Alaska, but it would
be recognizable globally.
Well, yeah, and it ties us to our home state, and it has a great meaning.
Mm-hmm.
So I normally, you know, go anti-cliche, but in this fact that, you know, there's 8 billion other people in the world that really is not cliche to, I think it is fitting.
I really like the name Rogue because we're going rogue. And we've also talked about the name Eve because it's E-V, Eve. And we love the movie WALL-E, where he says, Eve. Yeah.
So, I would lean more towards Eve instead of Rogue, because if there was a Rogue River in Alaska, I'd say, sure, let's do it. But the Rogue River is in Oregon.
I just like the meaning of Rogue. You know, it has, it speaks to what we're doing.
It does.
But we're going to have to have you guys vote and help us decide.
That'll be a whole separate day. Okay, a little bit of a breeze picked up, but I just want to throw this out there. We are going to need to do some work on this vehicle, especially if we mail our boxes down to Montana. I know the owner or seller will be very willing to help us out to a certain degree, but you know, we don't want to like take advantage of. So our thought was like, hey, we go to San Diego because we have resources there for parking. But if anybody is along the way to the East Coast or anywhere and would welcome us on their property and have some tools and maybe some expertise as well, because I know, I'm humble enough to admit, I know a little about a lot of things, but I don't know everything. And, you know, there are some things like wiring in an inverter and the outlets and getting all that wired up right. Like, I can hammer nails and all that like none other.
Mm-hmm. But we'll need some new tools to put new countertops and cabinets.
Yeah, in. So, you know, if you got a place and you'd be nice enough to let us park there and maybe give some tips on how to do things, we would potentially take you up on that offer. Because the idea of, you know, going to San Diego was like, hey, we can then jump into Mexico, buy some more antibiotics and meds for our
road trip
medical kit and whatnot. But that seems like an awfully far way to drive.
It's really
when we're going to Montana. So I don't know, everything is still fluid in our lives, but here's where we're at. And did we answer?
I think we answered everybody's questions.
I think we got it all.
Hopefully you guys enjoyed learning a little bit more about where we are right now, and I think we're back. Ben is feeling better.
Yep.
And we're pretty close to being ready to rock out of here.
I think July there's gonna be a lot of cool stuff happening.
I do too.
So hope this video was not too long. If you're still awake, make sure you, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. But I'm gonna send the drone up and get some awesomeness for you. Thanks for watching, and we'll keep you updated as life rolls.
Yep.
Ooh, there's a bee.